Let's welcome Meha Singla, Domain Research, Real Estate, CommonFlow.com. Meha, good to have you back on the show. All right, Pune, we did Bangalore last week. So tell me, Pune versus Bangalore for rental values, where do you get better rental yields?
Manisha, if you compare the top 5 rental markets of Pune to that of Bangalore, it is interesting to find out that in Pune there is maximum demand and availability of 1 and 2 BHK, while in Bangalore the maximum demand and availability of 2 and 3 BHK. Ideally so, because Pune is, apart from IT/ITS, Pune is also driven by automobile and educational centers. So there is a lot of demand for smaller configuration homes.
Okay.
In terms of rental yield, if you compare the top 5 rental markets of both the cities, Bangalore scores higher. The average rental yield per month is anywhere between 13 to 25 rupees per square foot for Bangalore, while for Pune it is 10 to 18 rupees per square foot.
Okay, that's interesting, Meha. So now let's just get down to then the top 5 rental markets on the basis of availability and what makes them stand out. Pune is the market that you're talking about.
Top 5 rental markets, 3 markets are spread across East Pune and 2 markets in West Pune. In East, there are micro markets such as Hadapsar, Wagholi and Kharadi. The demand in these micro markets is driven by RT parks such as Koregaon, IT Park, Magarpatra, Cyber City and Eon Free Zone, amongst others. In West, main micro markets are Baner and Wakar. The demand in these micro markets is driven by IT parks such as Panchshil Tech Park and MIDC Software Technology Park.
Okay, so that's for people who are looking to rent out a home, Meha. What about homeowners? Where does it pay to actually buy a home and then expect good rental yields in Pune? Must be the well-established centers, isn't it? Closer to the central business district of Pune?
Yes, Manisha, definitely. Top 5 rental yield markets are Hadapsar, Kharari, Viman Nagar, Shastri Nagar and Kalyani Nagar. Interestingly, 3 out of 5 micro markets are established micro markets having luxury home options within them.
Would you still bet on Pune market over Bangalore market for the next 12 months?
If you see the demand and supply scenario in Pune, it looks like most of the demand comes in affordable and mid-segment due to the automobile, industrial and educational and IT/ITS hub. Interestingly, the developers have understood it and they have launched in 2014 mostly affordable and mid-segment projects.
Mm-hmm.
So if you see in that perspective, the developers are not going wrong.
Okay. Meha Singla, thank you very much for coming in and giving us those rental insights.
Thank you so much.